Hello everyone, this is Helinks tutorial video 11, part 2, communication validation. In part 1, we learned how to configure communication. In part 2, we will learn how to validate it. At the dashboard, click on communication. In this page, we can view all the information about communication applications through these different tabs and verify them. Let's start with Goose Matrix. Plus signs are available next to each publisher, which is JO2 BPU, JO3 BPU, and JO4 BPU. If you open one of them, you can see the name of the Goose control block, the dataset name, Goose ID, App ID, MAC address, and the name of the subscriber. Next, open the Reports tab. As you can see, report control blocks have been created based on the inputs we specified for D400 gateway in the single line diagram. And buffered report control blocks have been made for the state signals or status signals, and unbuffered report control blocks for measurement signals. Datasets tab shows the dataset for the aforementioned report control blocks. And Inputs tab shows the input section for the gateway or HMI through the interface logical nodes. And the Goose message subscriber, which is JO1 BPU. You can view more information about each input or each dataset and report control block by clicking on them and viewing the properties section. So far, everything seems correct and the communication has been configured successfully. Thanks for your attention and see you in the next video.